you very much, Patrick, and let me first thank the organization of the dialogue and the UK presidency for this invitation. And I'll be actually very quick to explain what such an institution as the European Investment Bank, the EU Climate Bank, can help to address some of the issues here. And actually, we'll try to address that by doing more volume and more impact. More volume here in Glasgow, EIB has announced a tripling of its adaptation finance by 2025. And for us, it represents a significant increase and an important contribution to accelerating adaptation investments across the world. And second, more impact. We will be able to overcome the structural barriers to investment in adaptation only if we can increase also the impact of our finance. And for that, we will scale up investment for physical capital, natural capital, and human capital. And let me just give a few examples of those three. On physical capital, we will support investment in physical capital, in particular in cities, to help manage floods, to protect critical infrastructure related to water, agriculture, energy, transport, and health from more extreme weather. We've done that in Mozambique for the reconstruction and enhanced resilience of the water supply and wastewater infrastructure destroyed by the cyclones 2 years ago. We'll also support higher risk activity associated with innovative products and technology, and we think this is actually what the public bank has to do. For example, we are investing in the Climate Resilience and Adaptation Finance Technology Transfer Facility, CRAFT, with the first private sector fund dedicated to invest in growth equity in companies in Asia, Africa, and the Americas that provide data, tech-enabled services, and products to manage the risks and impacts amplified by the climate change. We are going to increase our investments in the resilience of ecosystems that can help protect cities by reducing water runoff, creating natural barriers to flooding, and reduce extreme heat in the urban environment. Nature is part of the solution. And finally, in terms of human capital, we also need to be smarter and invest in human capital. We are part of the AAAP initiative that is led by the African Development Bank, and that is also your initiative, Patrick, at the Global Center of Adaptation. And we also are implementing the City Climate Finance Gap Fund that is supported by the German and Luxembourg governments. And together with the World Bank, we will help cities across the globe realize their ambitions for both climate resilience and low carbon development by offering technical and advisory services for early stage preparation and planning. I will close here, but not without saying a point that Susanna just made, that in our strategy for adaptation, we will pay special attention to the least developed countries and the small island development states that need certainly our support. Thank you.